Hello and welcome, friends. Welcome to my channel, Six Pack Fitness. Why making a coronavirus vaccine is taking so much of time? We all are desperately waiting for the coronavirus vaccine, as most of us do feel that it's the only way to get out of this horrible coronavirus pandemic. Even though pharma companies are making certain sporadic announcements on the vaccine, but the question still remains as to when the vaccine will arrive and why exactly is it taking so much of time. All our expectations about vaccine is too high, and government is also laying billions of dollars in hope of getting the first-hand shots in their country for the citizens. But the problem is there is no vaccine that has yet proven effective. World Health Organization Director General Tedros Adhanom warned that there is no silver bullet at the moment and there might never be. Similarly, experts say there is still a long way to go before we know if any of the experimental vaccines will be effective, and longer still before any approved products are distributed around the world to offer a shot at global herd immunity. There are certain challenges for COVID vaccine production. The most important of them is uncertainty. The real challenge is hunting the unknown enemy. And talking about COVID, there are so many unknowns about the impact of any approved vaccines on the virus and whether they can stop transmission and ultimately the pandemic. David Morenz, senior advisor to Dr. Anthony Fauci, said, "Every attempt to make a vaccine is like a blind trial and error procedure in which you might succeed early in the process and you might not succeed even late in the process. Getting a vaccine within 6 to 12 months is possible, but it would take a lot of luck." Vaccinologist John Andrews said, "Development of an effective vaccine was not a sure shot. So it's dangerous for us to be putting all our eggs in one basket that a vaccine will become available and this is going to save the day, and forget to remain focused on what we should be doing this very moment. That included widespread testing, case identification and tracing, wearing masks, maintaining hygiene and social distancing. But looking at the amount of research and commitment of the governments all over the world, the picture is not all that dark. There are surely some reasons to be optimistic. More than 24 experimental vaccines are in human trials, and 6 of those candidates have advanced into large-scale phase 3 trials. Unlike HIV, which does not leave the body once it is infected, COVID-19 can be cleared from the system by a natural immune response, indicating that the right vaccines could do so. Early clinical trials induced both neutralizing antibodies, that is, molecules which can attach to the spikes of the virus and stop it from entering human cells, and T cells, which play a central role in the body's immune response and may be important in the long-term defense against the disease. Also, the outcomes of this vaccine trial is quite vague. There are a range of outcomes you can get. Even if the vaccine makes it to the phase 3 trial to evaluation by regulators, it may have a range of results. Vaccine efficacy is a spectrum of numbers. The question is, are you happy with 30% vaccine efficacy, or are you only happy if it has 90% efficacy? John Donnelly from US-based Vaccinology said that depending on what kind of protection was provided by the early vaccines, public health measures may have to continue for some period of time until further advancements were made. It may not be simply a matter of distributing the vaccine and going back to doing everything the way that we did it before. Now the question is, how long will the immunity last? Early studies does show antibodies staying only for a few months in the body, but still there are chances of reinfection after months or years after exposure. Due to this, we might need to take booster doses of vaccine to stay safe. But one group of scientists feel even if the vaccine remains effective for a few months, still it will give us time to make better drug or vaccine. Also, they feel the immunity from vaccine won't be short-lived like it does in viral exposure. Vaccines can be manipulated to give prolonged immunity. Also, the second concern is the results of the vaccine depends on how many people are vaccinated. The result of the vaccine turning the table in this pandemic depends on how many people are vaccinated. A vaccine ideally works by protecting a person from becoming infected by a pathogen. The more people that are immunized, the harder it is for that pathogen to spread in a community, reducing infection risk and increasing protection for everyone. Also, the part of the challenge with any COVID vaccine will be a sheer number game. Despite early efforts to ramp up manufacturing capability, there are likely to be shortages for months or years. depending on which candidates are successful. Supplies will become more stretched if two doses are needed per immunization or boosters after a short stretch of time. Vaccine hesitancy. Then there is a problem called vaccine hesitancy, where in people with access to such vaccines choose not to take the shots over safety concerns or a lack of trust in science or government. A poll by the Center for Public Affairs Research found only about half of Americans were prepared to get the vaccine. And this hesitancy is not limited to the United States. The biggest challenge is getting sufficient people vaccinated to induce herd immunity. And in some countries, it's probably not going to be a problem. And in others, it's going to be a huge problem. So our next concern is how much population should be vaccinated. There is a term called threshold for herd immunity. It is a percentage of people who should be immunized to significantly slow down the transmission of the disease. It is usually pitched at 60-70%. But some experts, in looking at how widespread and contagious COVID-19 is proving to be, suggest much higher figures. Dr. Kirman agrees the threshold for robust herd immunity will be in the 90s. The virus will continue to circulate if enough people are not vaccinated, which could open up another problem, apart from the ongoing risk of the disease. So far, the new coronavirus has been genetically relatively stable, but that could change over time. If immunization was not widespread or differed between countries, down the track, mutated forms of the virus may actually pose challenges if different strains capable of escaping vaccine control emerge. Most experts are optimistic that vaccines can be developed to prove some level of protection against COVID-19 and that they will be improved with further advancement. Testing and tracing, frequent hand washing, mask wearing, and social distancing will need to be maintained while vaccines are being rolled out. So the biggest takeaway is that people need to be diligent about doing the things that the authorities have recommended them to do to reduce the spread of this virus. And if you don't do that, technology like vaccines may prove to be disappointing. But if you do that, then technology could be a very important tool to complete control of the infection. So the conclusion is quite simple. Vaccine may or may not come. You don't know when it will come. But the thing is, you should always be ready to follow the authorities and do the things they have asked you, like wearing a mask, hand washing, keeping a social distance. That is the only thing which could save you for sure. So take care of yourself and stay at home and be safe.